Deaths and asphyxia is an important topic. What is the actual meaning of asphyxia? A means not, asphyxia means pulse actually. Asphyxia is not breathlessness but pulselessness, original Greek meaning. Sometimes examiner can slap a embarrassment on the face of us. Diatoms, discovering them in the bone marrow, it only happens if circulation is intact. That's the reason drowning cases may diatom can help you whether the person's circulation is there or he was killed and thrown into water, you can differentiate. Where there is an asphyxial death leading to cyanosis, how much minimum hemoglobin should be there, Nalini? 5 is the typical value for you to appreciate cyanosis in case of cyanosis, as what you can see here, in case of the asphyxial deaths is what you need to ultimately remember. Lipase is sympathetic. What is the meaning of it and where do you find it? Basically in the case of the hanging. Earlier they used to believe if a person is alive at the time of hanging rather than he was killed and made to hang, antemortem hanging versus postmortem, they thought it is a differentiator. The right eye is believed to remain open and the left eye closed, right? And left eye closed, and the left pupil is small and the right pupil will be dilated. That is called lipases sympathetic, is what need to be remembered. It occurs because of the unequal tension on the neck structures basically. So once upon a time it used to be thought as a sure sign of antemortem hanging, is what you need to remember. Where do you see a horizontal ligature mark is a very important question. I am very happy to see Balina, Naina and many more joining up. That's good, doctor. Without teaching, without meeting you, even for us evening is very boring. So there's a reason we want to spend 2 to 3 hours of time of us with you every day until the exam, because until March 2nd we are also restless. Anyway, from February 1st our new schedule is going to start for the next batch with anatomy. One of the excellent teachers, Dr. Muralidhar Reddy sir, in anatomy from Guntur Medical College, just like our Dakshinamurthy sir in orthopedics, you all liked his class. Similarly, we have Dr. Muralidhar Reddy sir from Guntur Medical College, an excellent teacher in anatomy, will be blessing the session with his tremendous class. So now doctor, horizontal ligature, what is your answer? Yes, it is basically the mark is usually seen in ligature induced strangulation. How do you define hanging, doctor, basically? When do you call hanging? It is basically when the neck, the constricting force, if it is the weight of the body, that is called as hanging. So what is the most specific and diagnostic feature of antemortem hanging? Dribbling of saliva, you want to say? Question number 23. I am happy to see Priya also participating in the answering. That's good, doctor. Please punch your answers. Yeah. What is your answer? Typically, it is the dribbling of saliva, which is considered to be the most specific and diagnostic feature, is what you need to remember. How much pressure is required to close the jugular veins? You like to say 5 kgs, Nanni says 5 kgs, but 2 kg kaafi hai. Jugular veins 2 kg, carotid arteries 5 kg, trachea 15 kg, vertebral arteries 30 kg. Like a mutton shop owner, you must be knowing how many kilos for each of it. Very clearly, doctor. That's good. That's good. Now, in case of hanging, when the feet of the victim are touching the ground, what is your conclusion? Shoot a possible answer. It's a case of partial hanging. Whenever the feet are touching the ground, in case of hanging, you call it as partial hanging. Generally, we wrongly think that if the feet touch the ground, it is not hanging. No, in partial hanging, feet can touch the ground, still the body weight can be able to lead to development of hanging. In which type of hanging, carotid arteries will be torn transversely basically. Only in one of these types of hanging only that much pressure will be applied. Carotid arteries ke liye how much pressure? 5 kg, jugular veins 2 kg, trachea 15 kg, all these kilos you need to know. Yeah. Question number 26, Shailu is proposing homicidal hanging. What is your opinion, Nalini? Homicidal, judicial hanging. In judicial hanging only, that much amount of pressure and from that much height they hang. In suicide may at most a small stool under the feet. That's the point. Where are the ligature marks are very very prominent, doctor, are typical examples of what type of injury you call it as? Some guesswork. Basically they are called pressure abrasions. Fundamentally, ligature mark is an example of a pressure abrasion. If you find pinpoint hemorrhages on the sclera and the thoracic serous membranes, what do you call them as? Are they paltaos or tardive spots? Basically, what are they called as? Like this subpleural hemorrhagic spots. They are called tardive spots. Pinpoint hemorrhages under the skin, sclera, or the thoracic serous membrane in case of the asphyxial deaths are all called tardive spots. It is fortunate to remember. Then what is the combination where homicidal smothering and traumatic asphyxia together is basically called as? Yes, doctor? Barking or throttling, you decide something. Question number 29. Yeah. So, question number 29 is basically called barking. So, what is barking basically? In 1792, during the days of Gray's Anatomy, William Hare, you killed 16 poor beggars and supplied their bodies to Dr. Robert Knox, who used to pay him very good amount of money for doing that. How he used to kill? He used to invite poor beggars, nicely make them drunk. Once they are drunk enough, he will wrestle them down to the floor and close their mouth and nostrils with his hand. So that he is doing smothering. Then, his friend used to do that, Hare. Then bark sits on the victim's chest and lead to traumatic asphyxia. So it's a combination of both smothering and traumatic asphyxia is all the story about the barking. So it is basically the person bark from whom that came. Now once more, examiner can ask in another way. Sitting on the victim's chest and closing his nostrils to cause asphyxial death is basically called barking, is what you need to be sure. In which kind of death, congestion of the face is maximum? Congestion of the face. Yeah? You have any guesswork to say, Dr. Gowd? 34. Online students can punch the answers. Yeah. You like to say hanging? Hanging. Yesterday also one Tollywood hero hung himself. So, Srinivas is proposing strangulation. Beautiful. Questions are simple, but answers also should be simple. So, this is a typical guy who was strangulated, where the congestion, obviously when strangulation occur, the venous drainage cannot occur into heart and face become typically congested. So, that is the idea. So, congestion. When will cave coronary will occur, doctor, in your opinion? I know what is the common tendency to answer. What is that? Fish bone, asphyxia is what your thought will go. Lot of people eat fish. Question number 35. What is that hallmark for the asphyxia to occur in cave? Cave coronary has nothing to do with coronary artery disease or heart attack. Remember, that's a common misnomer. Yeah, it simulates heart attack, hence called cave coronary. It occur in cave. Cave means in India drinking coffee, but caves are there, Irish caves, Irish pubs. So, intoxication. So, cave coronary is whenever there is an impaction of the food in trachea, when the intoxicated person is eating and he has consumed alcohol, then he is in a state of intoxication that lead to development of asphyxia. The person is otherwise well preserved. Now, if the strangulation is affected by compressing the neck in the bend of the elbow, what do you call it as? A very common word. If you are studying Harrison's internal medicine, doctor, how will you carry those books between reading room and the room? You will be holding in the elbows and carrying the Harrison. What your friend will say? Kya re Harrison mugging kar rahe kya? So that is called mugging. That is basically when strangulation is caused by the compression of the neck of the victim within the bend of the elbow, you call it as mugging. So next time your friend say, are you mugging books, means are you carrying lot of books? Then one more form of death is called garroting. This is a classical example. In this, what they will do? They will basically will be using the ends of a cord or a bow. In fact, in Spain, they will also use an instrument around the neck and then tighten the screw and kill the person. Okay, so that's called as garroting. It's called garroting chair. It's no more practiced in the modern civilized world. Even a criminal require a peaceful death. Throttling means manual strangulation in the form of compression of the neck by hand is called as basically throttling, is what you need to remember. All these are the features in drowning, except what? Except what? You find midriasis, not meiosis, in case of the drowning, is what you need to remember. Very happy to see Anita after a long time. So, all of our old students, we are having a chance to meet up. Tomorrow we will have a Sunday test. Mock test. And 2 to 5 a mock test, 5 to 8 we will have a discussion on that. So, every week we will have 2 mock tests in order to charge ourselves for the exam. Midriasis is what you see, not meiosis. You will find froth from the nose and mouth, water and weed in the stomach and lungs, and a wet heavy lung. They are all the features of the drowning. Now, doctor, if a child has drowned in water in a pond, what is the most consistent feature basically?
the water in the alveoli in the lungs is the most consistent feature. And basically, now we'll come back to this washerwoman hands everything. Now, what are the most common type of drowning, doctor? Nobody for committing suicide will really love to go and jump into water. It is a fearful experience. More easier is to hang to the rooftop. So what is the answer? Question number 39. Most of the times drowning is accidental. We should teach every child swimming. Very important. Lot of deaths can be prevented if people learn swimming, and learning swimming is 2 to 3 weeks activity. It's all the fun. One summer, if the child learns, throughout life he won't drown. So what is a sign that indicate that the death is anti-mortem? Weed and grass in the hands. That's good. Excellent. Do you see cutis anserina? The goosebumps on the skin and the washerwoman hands, we see, but they are not the signs of antemortem drowning. Cutis anserina is because of the any form of death due to rigor mortis of the erector pili. Washerwoman hands are merely the sign of submersion. They tell nothing about whether it is antemortem or not. That is what you need to be clear about. Then another important thing is post-mortem lividity on the face develops in drowning death, but it is not in a sign to say it is anti-mortem. So why will it basically appear on the face? Basically, the body comes to lie face downwards when suspended in water. Most dependent part becomes the face, and hence condition develops in the face is what need to be remembered.